Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today we're doing a 20-minute kettlebell workout. We're doing 40 seconds of work with 20 seconds of rest. We've got 10 exercises and 2 rounds. I'm using a 16-kilogram kettlebell. Just grab whatever weight you feel comfortable with today, and in the future, try to increase that weight as you come back to the workout. You will get stronger and you will increase muscle hypertrophy. We're working on some fundamental exercises today. I will show you how to progress these exercises. It's all about getting your form good and then increasing the intensity in the future. So without further ado, grab your kettlebell, let's go. So first exercise is gonna be the suitcase deadlift. We're gonna start with the right arm. And I want you to start with the kettlebell just outside of the right foot. We're gonna hinge at the hips and keep soft knees. Grab that kettlebell with the right hand. Keep your upper body engaged. Then we drive through the heels and we're going to extend the hips forward. So let's go now, 40 seconds of work with the kettlebell in the right hand. We're gonna lift it up, extend the hips forward, stand up tall and proud, come back down the same way. So we've just got a slight bend in the knees. And what we're doing is hinging at the hips. You're gonna make sure that you're keeping your core engaged and keep a nice neutral spine. The great part of this exercise is that the weight being on just one side is gonna mean that you're using a bunch of stabilizing muscles in your core, as well as engaging at the normal muscles that we use for a deadlift, such as the glutes, the lower back. That is our rest now. We've got 20 seconds of rest. So we're next going to stick that kettlebell outside of the left foot. And we're gonna do the same thing again. So we've got suitcase deadlift, but this time with the kettlebell in the left hand. So a few more seconds of rest. All right, let's get ready to go. So hinging at the hips. We're going to extend the hips forward, pick that kettlebell up. And make sure you're doing it slow and with control. Try and get into the habit, breathing out as you lift and breathing in as you lower. Five more seconds of work. Great job, take a rest. Next up, we've got goblet squats. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hold the kettlebell by the handles with two hands here. So we pick it up, we're gonna bring it, and we're gonna have it just in front of the chest here. And then we're gonna go into a squat by sending the hips back like you're sitting in a chair. So grab your kettlebell, let's go 40 seconds of work. So into a squat. Send those hips back. If you're struggling with your mobility, you can try and turn your toes slightly outwards. Might mean that you can get a little bit lower today. We all have different anatomy, so you need to find what squat position works for you. Over time, you want to try and get a bit lower, improve your mobility. But for today, just go as low as feels comfortable for you. We're about 5 more seconds. Okay, take a rest. Kettlebell goes on the floor, we've got 20 seconds of rest. So next up, we've got strict presses with the right arm. Now, it's important how we keep that kettlebell in the rack position. I'll show you now, you can use two hands to get it up there. So what you wanna do is you wanna have your hand going through this side of the kettlebell. You wanna keep your palm towards the midline of your body. And then you just extend above the head and back down again. What I don't want to see is the kettlebell pulling your hand away from your shoulder. That's what can put your shoulder in a compromised position. But if you keep your palm towards the midline of your body, keep nice and safe, and then we can do this exercise, work on building the shoulders, keep soft knees, engaged core, extend fully above the head. And take a rest. Okay, set that kettlebell down. We've got the same on the left side now. So again, we're looking for proper hand insertion, which means that the sort of handle is going across the palm here, and then you can lock your hands over the top of it. Again, palms towards the midline of your body. And we're gonna extend above the head. Try and think about keeping the bicep close to the ear at the top of each rep. Should have a nice straight line down your body. And as long as you're keeping that kettlebell towards the midline of your body, then we are preventing the risk of doing our shoulder some damage. Again, try and breathe out as you push up. And then you can breathe in on the way down. Okay, take a rest, set that kettlebell down. Next up, we've got Romanian deadlift. So here, I want you to start with the kettlebell inside of the right foot. The left foot's gonna be behind and that's gonna be on your toes. We're then gonna grab the kettlebell with the left hand, keeping your right leg straight with a slight bend in the knee. We're gonna extend the hips forward, lift that kettlebell up with the left hand, and then lower it back down. So it's all about this movement at your hip, this hinge that happens at your hip. So we're mostly keeping the right leg straight, just a slight bend in the knee, just to protect the knee. We keep an engaged core, neutral spine, and then we just extend those hips forward to lift, and then we're gonna push the hips back to lower. And then you should feel a nice stretch behind your right knee. Okay, take a rest. We're gonna do the same on the other side now. So we've got Romanian deadlifts with the left leg. That means the kettlebell is inside of your left foot and your right foot's behind on your tiptoes here. Again, keeping the left leg straight this time, grabbing the kettlebell in the right hand. So let's get ready to go. Lifting the kettlebell with the right hand, extending those hips forward, and then pushing those hips back. Always remember to keep a neutral spine. So you don't want to round your back when you're over in this position. You want to keep a nice flat back. And all the movement is coming from your hips. We've got 10 seconds. Okay, take a rest. Next up, we've got a deadlift to burpee. Now, a few different options of how you can do this burpee. So the deadlift, we've got two hands on the kettlebell. Again, we hinge at the hips, keeping the legs relatively straight, just a slight bend in the legs. We're gonna do a deadlift by lifting that kettlebell up. And then we're gonna take a step back down into a high plank position, step forward again, and then we go back to that deadlift. So let's go, 40 seconds. We've got a deadlift. We take a step back down into a plank position and step forward. Now, of course, if you want to progress this exercise, you can hop back like into a normal burpee. One thing I will say is make sure you take a step away from that kettlebell because you don't want to hit your head on that kettlebell. Now, if you really want to push it, you can add a push-up at the bottom too. So that, then we're in a full burpee. So take a rest, see how you feel with those. In the future, you can always progress them. You can regress them and take a step back, whatever you feel comfortable with today. Next up, we've got push-ups. So we wanna make sure that we work some of our chest today. Now, different options with the push-ups. Either keeping your elbows tight into the body, lower right down to the ground and push up, or knees on the ground and push up here. Whatever feels most comfortable for you. If these are a bit too challenging, then we can stay in a plank position, either with the knees up or the knees down. So, whatever you feel most comfortable with today, go for that. Next time you do this workout, try and go for something a little bit more challenging. You can always regress halfway through the exercise as well. So try a few push-ups and then maybe do a plank. Okay, take a rest, 20 seconds of rest. Next up, the last exercise of the first round. We've got bent over rows. So we keep our legs straight, slight bend in the knees. We hinge at the hips, grab the kettlebell with one hand, We're gonna row it up. We're gonna alternate which hand that we row it with each time. So, really important here that you keep a nice neutral spine, keeping your core engaged. And we just row that kettlebell up by bringing the elbow up. Try and get into a nice rhythm here, but making sure that it's a controlled movement, that you're keeping a nice neutral spine, keeping your core engaged. A few more seconds. Let's do one more. Okay, take a rest. That is the end of the first round. Grab a sip of water if you need. You can pause the video if you need an extra bit of rest. So back to the first exercise. Suitcase deadlift with the right hand. So, kettlebells outside of the right foot. Let's hinge at the hips. Extend those hips forward and lower again. So we're gonna repeat these 10 exercises now. Stick with me. You can do this. Obviously, if you need an extra rest, it's absolutely fine. You just pause the video, grab your breath, grab a sip of water, and come back in when you feel comfortable. Next time you do the workout, try and reduce those rests. It's all about just progressing slowly. Okay, take a rest. Good work. Next up, same on the other side. Kettlebell is outside of the left foot. So same thing again, just making sure you're keeping a neutral spine and an engaged core. All right, let's get ready to go. Kettlebell's in the left hand. Extend those hips forward. You've got a choice whether you'd like to set the kettlebell down between each rep. It will be a bit more challenging if you try and hold it off the ground for the whole duration of the exercise. You can regress or progress this exercise in the future. Okay, take a rest. Good job. Next up, goblet squats. So if you remember, we are holding the kettlebell by the handles, two hands, and we're gonna have a kettlebell in front of the chest. Then we go down into a nice low squat. So getting going in a few seconds. Grab your kettlebell. Let's go, front of the chest. Nice low squat. Drive up through the heels. Maybe see if you can get a little bit lower this time. These are getting a bit too challenging. Then set the kettlebell down and go for regular body weight squats. Just a few more seconds to go. Take a rest. Great work. Next up, we've got strict press with the right arm. So remembering that proper hand insertion position here, that's where we have the handle running along the palm. We keep it nice and tight into the body, kettlebells resting on the shoulder. And then we engage the core, we drive up fully above the head, trying to keep the bicep close to the ear, lower down with control. In this rack position, you can also keep the other hand on your hand that's holding the kettlebell, just to keep it locked in that position in front of you. Right, strong presses. Stay with me. Keep going. Let's do one more. And take a rest. Great job. Set that kettlebell down nice and safely. We've got the same with the left arm coming up next. If you're finding that it's rubbing a bit against your forearm, that is normal when you start kettlebells. It will get better over time. If it's really bothering you, you can always get sweatbands. Let's go. Left arm, 40 seconds. So as I was saying, you can get sweatbands that will just protect your arm, whichever you prefer. It does always feel uncomfortable at first, but you know, like anything new that you're starting, it always feels a little bit uncomfortable. When you do it enough times, your body will adapt. You have to trust the process. Just stick with me. We've got 5 more seconds. Can we do one more? Let's see if we can do one more. And rest. Good job. Romanian deadlifts coming up next. We're working the right leg first, which means kettlebell is gonna be inside of the right foot. Left leg's behind on our tiptoes here. And then we keep a nice straight leg with the right leg lifting with the left hand. Now, just like before, as I was mentioning, you have a choice whether you're gonna set that kettlebell down between each rep. It is harder to stop and hover, but make sure that you do stop. Don't just come straight back up like this. Try and get down, pause, and then lift. Or you can be setting the kettlebell down. It's a good form check to set it down, because you set it down, check your form, make sure everything's engaged, and then you lift up. Okay, rest, good job. Next up, same on the other side. So the kettlebell is inside of the left foot. Right foot's behind. We're picking up with our right hand this time. Make sure you've got everything engaged as you lift. Right, let's go. Lifting with the right hand this time. Sharp exhale when you lift. Inhale when you lower. Try and get into that habit always. It will really help with your form. It's also just a nice rhythm that you can get into. I always find it easier to get into a rhythm when I'm thinking about my breathing. 10 seconds. Good job, take a rest. Kettlebell's going to the end of your mat or the space that you're working in today. Because next up, we've got deadlift to burpee. Now remember, we've got a bunch of different variations, so just go with whatever you feel comfortable with today. Let's get ready to go. So, strong deadlift. Set it down, take a step back before you then step down into that plank position. Now, you might have done this workout a few times now. You might be coming back to it thinking, do you know what? I'm actually feeling all right now. So I think I'm gonna go right down into that push-up. And those are not easy. They will get your heart rate up. Okay, we've got a rest. Only a few more exercises this workout left. Oh, just 2 more. All right, we've got push-ups next. Okay, so working the chest now. Again, we've got a few different variations. See if you can push a bit harder today. Let's go. Strong push-ups. Fifteen seconds to go. Stick with me, you can do this. Keep going. Oh, they are never easy push-ups, but we've got one more exercise to go. Alternate bent over rows to finish. Right, so kettlebell in the middle of the mat. feet are slightly wider than hips, what we're gonna do, hinge at the hips, keeping your legs relatively straight. We're gonna alternate rolling that kettlebell up. Keep going. You can do this. Not long to go now. Just 10 seconds. Keep going. You got this. 5 seconds. And that is it. Well done for completing this workout. Thank you so much for joining me. If you enjoyed that, then please leave me a comment. Let me know where in the world you're doing this workout from today. Like the video. Subscribe to my channel and click the notification button. Make sure you do a cool down now. I'll link a video for that in the corner. Thank you so much for joining me, guys. I'll see you on the next workout.